Hello there, and welcome on back to the Cozy Club, my friends. My goodness, Dwayne Frank Wolf, the Jungle Cruise main character, has absolutely supercharged and changed the faction entirely. And on today's video, we're going to break down everything you need to know about Frank and why he's definitely worth going after. Also, guys, this week we have a metric ton of information, like going through Raya, one of the best new characters in the entire game, all the rescue rangers that we properly should give a video in detail how they work as a whole, why you might be using Captain Jack Sparrow over Moana, and every bit of adventure faction info you could possibly want. But if that's not enough for you, yesterday we did a lot of testing. I stream every single Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Link is down on the description and in the comments below to join me on stream. So follow that if you want to see some more live testing. But my friends, we're going to be breaking down all you need to know about Frank the Tank. And before we get started with today's video, you can expect a little something like this in your battles.
The just bring it, says Jericho.
It's on! It's on!
As always, Cozy Club, we have a new tradition of question of the day. Go ahead and leave down in the comments below, QOTD, colon, and answer the question. Today's question is, out of all of the characters within DSA, it seems like the adventure faction was really pre-selected. Which characters would you add to the selection? Is it someone like Maui? Is it someone like Scrooge McDuck, who would be my personal choice that definitely led the adventures throughout our childhood? But let me know down below, which characters should be added or you hope will be added to the adventure faction? Alrighty, Cozy Club. Well, I don't even know where to begin with this absolute beast of a human and beast of a character. We've got ourselves Frank Wolf, the newest legendary to come into the game. And I say legendary because his stats are absolutely insane and his abilities are just incredible. Everything that he does on the battlefield, Dwayne Johnson is just an absolute terror. And we're going to break down all of those abilities and his stats and really show you guys why this guy is so just absolutely nuts. Now, one thing that makes him so great is if you look at him from a 3-star to a 7-star level, you know, he is in the defense class, which is going to hold him up just a little bit as far as needing to get those star levels, as his survivability and health is going to skyrocket the more stars that you have on him. However, because his abilities are so great, he's still going to get the job done even at early star level. So if Glue does decide to sell individual packs for the upcoming Summoner Showdown, definitely grab some of those to at least unlock him at base. But let's go ahead and jump into these stats at a maxed out Frank Wolf so that you guys know exactly what you're going to be getting your hands on. Now, his offense for a defense tank character is going to be 2,221. Now, for reference, if we want to look at a character that's somewhat similar, you've got Beast over here sitting at 2,400 with an offense stone. So definitely very comparable to Beast with his overall damage that he does. But Frank doesn't need to do the damage. Frank has his pet Jaguar and all the other things that he does and the utility that he brings to complement his entire kit. Now, offense is great. His defense is over that 1,000 stat line, which is just phenomenal. Absolutely crazy. Some of the highest defense in the game next to Beast as well. His health is some of the highest we've seen with 33,000. Again, really only Beast and Baymax can rival that kind of survivability. And we're talking about legendary characters that you've had to farm and get all these other characters to unlock. Frank is just insane. And so much so that if you're only investing in a few characters, and like you're a chubby dolphin, Frank is the guy to grab. I mean, he's going to be the cheapest bang for your buck. Great character out the gate. But I'm getting ahead of myself here. So looking at the rest of his stats, he's got decent crit chance. His lead is going to help with that anyway. Crit power is okay. Speed is at a healthy 150. Now, that's going to go ahead, and if you have just no stones on him, it's at 131. A little bit on the slower side, but still very, very fast for DSA tank standards. But then he's got 33% tenacity. His survivability is just off the charts to begin with the way that his abilities work. So if you compare him to some of these other legendaries that I'll bring up right now, you guys are going to tell that he definitely holds a candle to some of the best characters in the game. Obviously, not matching offense powers of someone like Hercules, but still can hold a candle to some of the best characters within DSA. So Let's go ahead and jump into his abilities. Now, Glue, if you're listening, this is the absolute blueprint of how you make an incredibly well-synergized and just a character that feels like it should be in the faction that it belongs in. We've got a new wild character in the adventure faction, and Frank's moves are going to complement all of that really well. Now, starting off with the basic, you've got Crushed Coconut, and this is a strong basic attack by multiple meanings in the book. Now, first and foremost, you're going to go ahead and deal some great solid damage, as you can see down below. But in addition to that, you're going to give yourself a chance with, depending on how many adventurers on the team, like we're talking about with that synergy, Frank is going to go ahead and give himself the chance to grab offense up and deal some great damage. Now, if that was not enough, if he has a helpful effect, hence the offense up, he's going to do a guaranteed crit. So you're getting some big, strong, basic damage, but you combine that with the Jaguar and all the assist, and you've got yourself one of the best basics that we've had in a long time. Not to mention that, synergizing with his leadership that we'll get to in a little bit, you'll also be removing as much turn meter as about Honey Lemon or Olaf, which is just an extra chef's kiss there. I don't even know how to begin to talk about this next ability, the Backside of Water. Now, the Backside of Water is hands down the best overall ability that I have seen for one character within the game with no cooldown whatsoever. Now, the Backside of Water right now is currently bugged. It's bugged in the game and it's still absolutely bonkers. It's going to go ahead and you're going to have a base chance to do an AoE removal of 40% turn meter plus 10% of each adventurer ally. So you're going to see it here multiple times, but as Frank dumps the water all over the opponents, you're going to be stripping just gallons and buckets and any other water pun you want to throw in there of turn meter, resetting them completely, essentially. And outside of Beast, Bell, and a couple other legendaries, you're going to just have such a big turn meter advantage that when Frank does indeed get a turn, or if you have a low star Frank and you Hero Hamada upgrade him, you're going to be giving your entire team a very fast advantage on the field. But in addition to that, guys, this is where things just get crazy. He's going to give himself defense up, 5 stacks if you're with a full adventurer team of undefeated, or undefeatable, I'm sorry, and 5 stacks of protect. It just gets out of control. Frank is truly a beast, and the Backside of Water is just the absolute move that ties it all together and gives you one of the best abilities, and you know what? The best ability for both raids and PvP, and he's definitely just, with just this ability, again, I've said it before, this could be his only move, and it would still be rock freaking solid. Now, moving on to his special B, a very vine maneuver. Do not sleep on this guy. This is absolutely a huge, huge ability as well. Obviously, anything to the Backside of Water is going to get a little overshadowed, but a very vine maneuver. Let me break down what this move does. Now, first and foremost, you're going to go ahead and put defense down on everyone, which is going to be a nice kind of synergy with some of the other adventurers. You're going to be putting those harmful effects down. But if Frank does have a helpful effect, he's also going to be putting 2 stacks of vulnerable out on the field, setting up the rest of your team for some big crits, and that's going to synergize that entire adventurer faction. Now, not only that, though, he's going to give all of your teammates defense up, and he calls Lily to assist, which we have covered Lily, but with just zipping by, Lily is going to be removing turn meter from the enemy and giving your own team turn meter. So there's just a whole lot going on between both of these moves, and it can really give yourself a huge advantage to start off the battle. In fact, I'll talk about this on a video later this week, but this faction just takes some of the most thought processes per battle, and you really have to think about what you're doing. It might not all be just use Backside of the Water and be done. There's a mix and match of different things depending on who you're facing. Now, altogether, yet again, just a very solid move that will be used regardless of magic when Lily uses it, as well as when Frank uses his, Lily will use hers. So just a lot of craziness. Also, as an added bonus, there's just something sweet about watching Frank do a little spin as he goes down the zipline. Let's check out this passive, Not Kitten Around. Now, if you guys want to know more about Proxima, I'm going to be having a video coming out after this one talking about why Proxima is hands down the best summonable unit within the game. But let's just take a look at the first part before we get into Proxima. Checking it out, if any adventurer character goes below 30% that is on your team, Frank is going to gain a Protect, which is going to help him kind of get this, you know, the kitten out as fast as possible. But on top of that, if it's Lily, he's going to be getting 30% turn meter as well as Lily. And even more so, check this out. This is where things get out of control and really feel like a legendary. Frank gains 5% offense, 5% defense per Protect, Undefeatable, and Evasion, which, spoiler alert, but this, he's going to have a metric ton of all of these buffs, giving him some really even more amped up stats that we talked about earlier, amping those numbers from 2,200 offense to way up high, up to a stack of 10. You can get well above 3,000 offense and just buku amounts of defense. So his passive, without it just being Proxima, is a very, very solid passive. And again, guys, if you don't want to miss any of my videos, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell, as over 50% of you guys are not subscribed. I'll be having my Proxima, the best summonable unit video coming out. And we've got some really cheeky teams that I'm going to be showing you guys on that video. So let's go ahead and move on to the leadership and we'll look at a battle. Alrighty, Captain of the Jungle Cruise, his leadership. Now, Frank is obviously a pure adventurer leadership, but this is the first leadership in almost a year, which is ridiculous, outside of like Club Conquest. Rapunzel had a new lead that came out, but this is about it, and it is a dang good one to boot. Now, he's going to be giving all adventurers 18% crit chance, but on top of that, whenever an adventurer deals a big-time crit hit, you're going to go ahead and you're going to give that adventurer 10% speed meter, as well as reducing the targets by 10% as well. Also, you're going to have amazing survivability. Whenever your units fall below 30% as an adventurer, they're going to gain both evasion and they're going to be gaining an undefeatable, which is giving them massive amounts of survivability. Right here, you guys can see in the bottom right and full screen, check it out as Hercules does the big time. Your whole team is dead to my entire team, and my team just kind of wipes it off like it was nothing. Big time survivability, great turn meter, just manipulation in general, and then high damage crits to boot. And on top of that, also in raids and on all club adventures, you're going to be able to get guaranteed crit at the start of the battle, haste, and on top of that, you'll be able to get an extra turn when you fall 30% health or lower. So Frank has great use in both the raid and PvP as far as a leadership standpoint, and this is what is making the case that Frank is all around one of the best characters within the game when you're looking at all of the game modes. Now, we've got the tier list coming out, but I'm just going to tell you guys right now, I'm going to probably spoil it. He's S tier, and there's almost no hesitation in my breath when I say that. This guy is truly a beast of a character and just offers so much in every single game mode. All right, Cozy Club, so we've been through the stats. We've been through why his abilities are just crazy ridiculous. Now I want to go ahead and I'm going to quickly take you guys into a battle. Now, later this week, I'm going to have the best adventurer teams, and there's a lot more that meets the eye, and there's also a lot more free-to-play friendly teams, but I'm going to show you how he works on the battlefield live with you guys, and then in addition, we'll kind of break down what's happening. I won't talk about some of the things that you're definitely going to have questions on because I'll save those for later videos, but just pay attention to Frank and everything that he does really well within this battle. All right, Cozy Club, so here we are in an evenly matched live battle, and I'm going to show you guys, even against a speed lead, how Frank the Tank is going to do really well and how he synergizes and supercharges the adventurers. Now, we're going to open up with this lead, and we're going to use Raya's second ability. And Raya's going to have her own video, but this ability makes her absolutely crazy because it gives the ability to take all that turn meter twice, give it to your own team. You're also going to be activating Lily's passive, which is going to be kind of cleansing or helping out Frank, putting harmful immunity on him, and overall just getting the whole engine behind this machine working. So here we go. We've got our team ready. We got Proxima, which we'll talk about later in a video. But we're going to go ahead. We're going to use Proxima's first turn, kind of burn through these. Raya's getting that instant turn after using Warrior's Fury because of all that turn meter she gave to herself. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to go and get the ball rolling with Tuk Tuk, giving our adventurers even more turn meter. Does Hercules have beef with like off-screen cameramen? I don't know what that was. And he's kind of left done, right? There's not a lot he can do. And yes, Raya did the majority of this. We're trying to show off Frank here. But let me show you. So we've got, you know, we'll go ahead and do the zip line on the front row here to show Frank going through, twisting on out and getting that big damage out there. But on top of that, Frank is about to get his turn, which is going to really just end the enemies. Any chance of maybe this Rapunzel getting some the incantation up and reviving everyone. We're going to drop the water, reduce all of the turn meter on the field, watch the bottom left as all of my people get their turns ready to rock and roll, and then it's game, set, match. I mean, it's Frank does, I mean, look at the damage just on his basic. Everything this man does is absolutely ridiculous. Proxima's going to assist here with him, and you guys can really start to see just what this man is capable of outputting, both with the protects and the tanking and the insane health. But then on top of that, guys, the amazing amount of turn meter reduction and solid damage that he can do. So yes, that was a very quick battle and we didn't get to see too much Frank, but we've got a lot of videos that are going to break down the best adventurer teams and how they kind of all work together. I plan on doing this series that we talk about each character, and then I'll have the full teams revealed so you guys know exactly how to use them when Summoner Showdown comes up and you're able to test out these characters. So, Cozy Club, after this video, let me know. Is Frank the Tank just absolutely ridiculous like you thought? Is he truly a legendary without being one? He is definitely one of the best characters in the game, and he's been a lot of fun figuring out all the things that make him work. Now, we've got a lot more that I didn't go into about Frank that we will on the Proxima video coming after this one. But hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video, and until next time, stay cozy.